Hello and welcome. Serial Peripheral Interface, or SPI, is a synchronous serial communication interface specification commonly used for short-distance communication, primarily in embedded systems. SPI devices communicate in full duplex mode using a master-slave architecture, usually with a single master. The master device generates the frame for reading and writing. Multiple slave devices may be supported through selecting them individually. From the 2023.1 version of the software, SPI Slave is supported on 4th generation HIL404 and HIL606 devices using the GPIO pins on the backplate of the devices. We recommend that you use a standard B2CF 16-pin female connector to easily connect with the GPIO. The SPI bus specifies 4 logic signals: serial clock coming from the master, MOSI data output from the master, MISO data output from the slave, and chip select, which is output from the master and indicates to where the data is being sent. To configure the SPI slave component, you have to configure the message, read, and write frames, as well as the message output. All properties are defined as a list of Python dictionaries. The write frame defines the write command coming from the SPI master. Using this message, the master can change the value of the slave register on the specified address. The write frame must contain the command, address information, and the register data field. The read frame defines the read command coming from the SPI master. Using this message, the master requests data from the slave at the specified address. Read frames must contain command and address bots. The command and address bots of the read and write frames must start from the same bit and have the same length. The message output defines the structure of the data that is returned as a response to the read frame. The output frame defines the structure of the slave's answer to the message from the master. Message output frames must contain a register data field. The register map defines the list of registers on the slave device, their addresses, types, lengths, and endianess. These registers define the inputs and outputs of the SPI slave component. To demonstrate this SPI slave feature, let's look at a setup consisting of a microcontroller from the Texas Instruments C2000 family, which behaves as the master controller. The microcontroller sets the status of the drive and the reference speed. Once the simulation is started, we can run the SPI master controller, which enables the drive system and sets the speed to 50% of nominal speed. The data structure can be seen using the SPI analyzer tool. Here we can see that we used 8 bits for the command and address specifications, while we used 16 bits for register data. In this demonstration, the command for reading from the master is set to 0 and the address register is set to 1. The data register is defined in the registers tab. In this demonstration, we are using 2 1-byte registers, and since the registers are implemented as an array, our 16-bit register data will cover both of them. The machine status register address starts from 0x01, while the machine speed register address starts from 0x09. Thank you for watching.
Check the video description for more resources on this topic, including how to download and get started with Typhoon HIL Control Center for free. You can also visit HIL.academy to access free courses, expand your HIL testing skill set, and get certified. Subscribe to our channel to get notified about new content.